Oh, my gods, you're ugly. You turn milk green and a magister's red coat black. My mistress Alice might fancy you, though. She has a taste for the odd, if she ever makes it back. The magisters with the red coats chased her into the woods. They'll be sorry. Oh my gods! Oh my god, stop looking at me! You're making my venom itch!
Smells of lavender and charred flesh. It's almost homely. Almost. Is that her eye? Did she pluck out her own eye?
Stand back a bit there, I'm not feeling very well.
Rat problems go, this one is a doozy. Rats.
You won't take it off me! You won't take it off me! The book! Alice's book! You won't take it off me!
Ah!
my God, stop looking!
Glad to see you well. Until later, then.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped.
Back for a return visit, are you?
Well, don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
And I don't come visit you, Tun. Who will?
Yep.
Wouldn't you like to know? Back again, eh? Looking for anything in particular?
Among friends. Never forget it. How are you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Have it, you.
Buying or selling?
Keeping it together, Bree. I'm all right. Too much. You're safe among friends. Never.
What's up, Chief?
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Try as he might, Tarquin cannot hide a small flash of surprise.
Where did you hear that precisely? Never mind. The Aetiran is a children's fable, nothing more. Supposedly a wand with an infinite capacity for source. Pure nonsense, I assure you. Really? Well, perhaps that says more about the caliber of their intellect than anything else. Such a device would be a gross overconcentration of power. It could purge the entire world of all source. Luckily, the laws of the universe render such a thing impossible.
Be on your way now, my dear. Perhaps we'll have matters to discuss again later.
Keep distant. My own demons haunt me too closely. I cannot also bear the burden of yours.
Ah! hear that a certain Magister Belworth has expired. Good to see you again, Governor. Heard you're the new champion. Well done, I say.
Are you? No.
The tigers fly. The leopards lie, and you, oh! But I know you, don't I? I have seen you in the night, the awoken one, hounded by dying gods. Just a dream, of course.
Oh, it's you again. Great.
Impressive. Dare say the spirit of the one stronger in you than anyone else I've seen. Even Murga.
Well, there you are. Been trying my hand at a few bows and such like, you asked. Hope you like what you see. Same to you.
Thank you.
He looks up from his mat.
Your war owl came. I confess, I had no idea just how grave the situation had come to be. The Black Ring, back, for all that's holy. I've informed Lord Kem in Arx. Thank you sincerely for your service.
He tosses you a pouch.
It's all there. You have your money and my gratitude with it. Please, I'm busy.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill. Please, hurry. Anything you can find out, anything you can do to bring her home. She cannot be lost.
See you.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill
and kill the lone wolves all.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
yield or not, I fight.
The spirit stands with her feet apart, arms at her sides, palms up. She appears to be chanting something, perhaps a prayer to the sky, but you hear nothing. You are a dancer, a lover, a jester. But then the death fog takes the forest and all you know is gone. The screams of your people echo in your heart. You become a warrior. You die fighting, all play forgotten.
You know him? Are you his friend? That man, the bad man, he likes to hurt people. He hurt me real bad.
He slurps something.
He don't work. Huge.
He offers her.
I do not.
I knew an elf.
We eat
secrets.
He grabs.
Hurt someone.
I do not help.
He squeezes her jaw tight.
Where?
Do what you like. You do not find them. Not from me.
Roost to
friend of yours?
Even in the
God will
Roost
that right. A mystery. Nice of you. Looks like the Silver Claw failed. Finally. Thing I love about this place. Like a tr-
He looks at you.
Wait!
Thank you.
Thank you. The Divine Order? What the devil? The contract seems to predate Alexander's ascension, too.
He's gone. It doesn't hurt anymore. You did it. You saved me from the bad man. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
The spirit's chest heaves in short, hard bursts. Its face is pinched into a tight sneer, fists balled up at its sides. It falls to its knees and grabs its matted hair in two fists, then rips. The spectral mats break away and reappear.
Shove your questions. Swallow nails, you. 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 Does it matter? They won't stop. Not till they're all dead. They ain't what you think. They'll do anything to survive. You'll get what's coming to you. The good guy. Everyone's their own good guy.
He catches a string of spittle with the back of his hand and wipes it away as a malevolent grin spreads over his face.
God did. Do us all a favor and go die.
He scratches at his scarred face with spectral nails, digging deep grooves that instantly vanish.
No. No, no.
You made the bad man go away. You did it. He can't hurt me now.
The child smiles a ghostly gap-toothed grin and waves goodbye.
He's gone. I guess this means I can leave. I hope the next place is better. This was a bad place. Bye, and thanks. If I could give you the biggest hug in the world, I'd give you the even bigger one. I love you.
The surface of the mirror ripples with a sickly haze. As you gaze into its surface, the haze forms shapes, and the shapes jerk into a figure. You see the outline of a skull, perhaps once an elf, though the flesh is all but rotted from his bones. What remains is the flat, dull colour of Sick. Behind him march ornately clad Black Ring. The picture flickers, fades, then returns in full relief. Beneath the din of the marching soldiers, or perhaps alongside it, a voice snags in your mind, like a fishhook in an open eye. It makes a demand. Tell it if you killed another Godwoken. The image strains and flickers again. Each time it comes into focus, a dull ache squeezes your head like a vice. Tighter, tighter, unbearably tight. The image flickers and fades to a hazy sheen once more, and the pressure vanishes. The haze swirls. There's no denying what you saw. The Black Ring itself is hunting you, or at least paying others to do so. It's impossible to tell who might be working for them. You eye your companions.
Life's full of surprises. That's what makes it fun and horrifying.
I know you come. I know you do. I know I only have to wait.
Please, not now.
He holds out his hand, index finger forward. A spark crackles between you. Visions flash before your eyes. You using the air to cow your foes, or mastering water to leave them cold and helpless, or watching them fall as the earth moves beneath you.
Choose.
He touches the tip of his finger to yours. Your mind opens. And a secret of the air implants itself within you. He dips his head in thanks, raises his in. You are running through a barren landscape. Brambles and weeds scratch at your ankles. Your heart is pumping acid, but you can't stop. Something catches you around the chest and you fall. The rough ground scrapes burns into the flesh of your bare arms, your knees, your face, you as you skid to a stop. Footsteps approach. That's the Scion, a rough voice calls. Kill him. They tried to hide you. They put you in a cellar. They put you in a cave. They put you in the hills. They put you in a pit. In the end, Roost found you anyway. He tried to find your memories by drilling a hole in your skull. It didn't work, but you were finally free. You are a young elf, very young. Still, the memories of eons dance inside you. You watch them like a play behind your eyelids. You are asleep in your family home when Roost's people steal in like a plague. A hand over your mouth, a hurried journey through the forests. You won't tell Roost how to find the others. The end comes quick.
Please, not now. Something's wrong in the camp.
You hear the roar of fire. He turns his gaze towards the corpse of Lone Wolf Pigsbane. His peeping skull cracks into a... The spirit's grin lingers as the spectral flames around him fade. Skin reforms around his skull. He is a handsome man with gentle eyes. He waves and vanishes. The whiff of chemistry assails you. The spirit of the Widowmaker gives you the broadest hook of a smile. You have set him free. He's ready to depart. He fades away, gone forever to the Hall of Echoes. She gazes at the dwarven lone wolf, adoration in her eyes. She gazes at the dwarven lone wolf, adoration in her eyes.
Careful now, that's a trap.
If Hardwin were to receive her head, it would make his day. I'll leave that with you.
He raises a hand in salute, then vanishes into the ether.
Neutralize this thing before it does damage. That looks dangerous. I should neutralize this thing before it does damage. That looks dangerous. But maybe I can do a trap. Better give it a wide berth.
the Fletcher trembles before the mass of bodies littering the camp, then looks you in the eyes.
They're dead. That means I can leave. A ship? A bit of sea air could be just what I need to relax. Decide what comes next.
He reaches for your hand and shakes it, his eyes smiling.
It's a deal. Must be moored off the Driftwood Harbor, right? I'll meet you there. Thank you.
I know you come. I know you do. I know I only have... I am fine. I am fine when I return to my people. I hold secrets. I hold truths. I am a scion, a keeper of memories, a keeper of my people. I see much, and I see you. You are my honor, that is all. They take all the scions, one by one. They make us bleed. They stop us from remembering for our people. Do we return now? To the others? My people wait for me nearby. Yes, yes, thank you. I see you so clearly. I see the goodness in you. Let's go!
Away from me, you love.
The ghostly elf stands protectively. You are a warrior.
We continue. We go on.
My baby, my girl, there you are.
Mother!
My dearest friend, the one who saves me.
You give us everything.
Thank you for helping me. Without you, I am already dead.
You save us all. My girl is back. Our scion is back.
I know what you need, and I can help you. We can help you.
She crouches down, placing a hand on the earthen ground.
Can you hear them? Their roots stretch beneath us, even now. Yes, they are cut down, destroyed and defiled. But our roots run deeper than any know. Our roots cross the world many times over. I will link you. You will hear them. They will feed you, increase the source in you. Increase the power.
She leans toward you, her veiled eyes directed toward the ground. The slightest of smiles plays over her lips, then vanishes.
A space inside you clears. You have room for more source, You have room for more everything. You have room for the whispers of the trees. Hold your hand to the ground. I hold my hand over yours. We breathe together. We call the spirit of the trees to us. Close your eyes. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale.
With each in-breath, the voices flutter in, whispers at first, then gentle murmurs like water over rocks. The wind of the voices enters you as you and Sahela breathe together. It travels down your throat, into your belly, around your heart. Suddenly, your blood runs icy cold, then warms again. The wind seems to search you for space it can inhabit, but it is expelled with your next out-breath.
Ah, you are. You are replete. You open yourself to a great deal of source already. There is no space for us. No space for the trees. There is little more to do then. I must go, and so must you. But take this. Perhaps it helps you on your journey. You feel my gratitude in it. You feel my thanks.
I give you something too. A thanks.
Take this spear. It destroys evil. It helps you. You help us more than you know. We make arrangements. We travel soon. I must meet someone who can help us. I say no more than this, but I do wish you good luck. And perhaps we meet again someday.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Please, I'm busy.
He recoils in disgust. But then, recognizing her face, he grins.
It's a grim day that such gore would bring me pleasure. But Helen Everhart's death was wrong, and this goes some way to righting it. Please, allow me to reward you. please. I'm busy. Please, I'm busy.
Careful! I spotted a trap. That rainbow's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
The couple notice you approach. The man offers a cheery smile. The woman watches you a little more warily, her arms crossed in front of her.
Greetings.
Greetings. The only thing worth knowing is that you should get out of this place as soon as you can.
Audrey, it's true. There's nothing for us in this place anymore. I wouldn't want some unsuspecting traveler to get lured in by this.
The man half shrugs and half nods, agreeing to disagree.
The open road. And a new life at the end of it, hopefully.
Fulton, our business is our business. Remember what Carl Van told us.
The man nods.
We don't know where we're going, but we're definitely not going back. There's no reason for anyone to go back where we came from unless they have a death wish.
That rainbow's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Fine spot, isn't it?
The slight person.
Fine spot, isn't it?
The slight.
Somewhere better than here, maybe.
Rainbow's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder where it leads.
Somewhere better than here, maybe.
That rainbow's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder where it leads.
Somewhere better than here, maybe.
That rainbow's beautiful.
Don't you shush.
Shh!
Beth. I know they're still here. My apologies for my idiot friend, but we could really use your help.
You won't believe it.
He won't believe it, Mabel. He'll think we're mad cows.
Truth is, kind sir, that we are not, in fact, cows. At least not as such.
We're people. Captives, to be exact. Enslaved by the witch. You're not here to visit Alice Elysian, are you? I told you not to trust him.
No, you didn't, Geraldine. Now, shush. I'm going to ask him anyway.
But what if she finds out?
Geraldine, how could things possibly be worse than they are now?
I can think of a few ways.
Just get us something to drink. What my friend here means to say, kind sir, is that there's a cure for our condition. Alice Elysian has it in her house. If we could drink it, we could then regain our former forms, as it were, and steal away.
Don't mention the rats.
For God's sake, Geraldine.
The witch ain't here.
What my friend wishes to say is that Alice went into the cloister wood collecting herbs and hasn't been seen in some time. But that there, just down the way, is her house. She has a frog. You can't miss it. Would you mind awfully procuring for us a small potion that Alice Elysian keeps in her cellar? We'd rather like to, you know, assume our rightful forms and toddle off. Thanks ever so.
Thank the gods.
I humbly thank you. You won't regret it.
Good news, definitely.
Shush, Geraldine. What's the bad news?
Well, that's no good.
You have it, Geraldine.
Oh, Mabel, I couldn't do that.
I insist.
Okay, then, thanks. I'll have it.
Mabel gives Geraldine a side-eyed look, then sighs.
Go on, then.
Look. We're cows who were once people who were enslaved and bewitched by a nasty old, witch. We don't have much to offer.
Wait!
But the potion is of no use to anyone but us. I used to sell recipes in Driftwood. I can do that again. Anything you want.
And I'll tell you where my secret stash is.
You have a secret stash? You think it's still there?
I hope so. Shh! He'll hear us.
I was famous for them, I'll have you know. All right, free, fine.
Oh, stuff. Lots of stuff. I know where it is. I'll mark it on a map for you. When I have fingers again, of course. Great?
Yes, great.
That's totally...
Mabel snorts, but you can see that she's fuming.
Yes, totally me. Thanks, Mabel.
Geraldine listens with bated breath.
It takes a while.
I'm happy for you, Gerald.
I never see an ordinary... Oh, hi! Oh, that. Didn't I mark it on your map? It's near the windmill out in the meadows. Pretty spot. You'll like it. That'll teach you to make assumptions then, won't...
Mabel gives you a disgusted look.
Well, bug.
Bye, then.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Buying or selling?
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Back again, eh? Looking for anything in particular? Suit yourself.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Back for a return visit, are you?
Well, don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Yep.
Glad to see you well. Until later, then.
How you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Big Marge's spirit pecks and pecks at you. It causes no physical pain, but you can feel her beak pecking at your very soul. Peck, peck, peck.
We may have found what Geraldine and Mabel are looking for.
Well, there you are. Been trying my hand at a few bows and such like, you asked. Hope you like what you see. Shame to you.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Mabel gives you a disgusted look.
Well, bugger.
you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Within the stone garden's walls, peace be thy immortal fortune, relieved of toil, free of indignity, until thou art called to serve. The masked creature grunts three times at the sight of you. It reaches its arm out. Clasped in its hand is a crumpled parchment. You take the page, and the servant returns to its hollow existence.
This won't be of any use.
No keyhole, no handle. There must be a hidden mechanism.
This is quite the antiques collection. This is quite the antiques collection. No keyhole, no handle. There must be a hidden mechanism. This is quite the antiques collection. No keyhole, no handle. There must be a hidden mechanism. I smell sauce in the air, and something else too, something rancid. This flesh.
flesh and bones severed and stitched. Perhaps some sort of necromancy? This flesh.
You feel tough wood and tougher steel under your claws. You gently sing a song in the old tongue of the lizards, and your chest creaks open. Welcome back, Consul Zara. It hisses as you reach inside, pulling out your fire whip. The pilgrimage takes its toll. You've walked upwards of 20 leagues, yet Arx is 40 more. You sit at the base of a looming statue and sip from your flask, grateful for a moment's rest. You kneel and pray at the stone cross. You know your words go unheard. You know you speak only to soil and bone. But you aren't praying for him. You are praying for you. You lie back on the riverbank's edge, eyes closed, waiting for the fish to bite. This is the life. You open your eyes to take in the blue skies, but another sight awaits. A gaunt elven face, sliced by a chilling smile.
This